SharePoint's a secure place to store, organize, share, and access information from any device. I'm going to take you on a little tour about what SharePoint looks like. Jermaine, you want to talk about the three different types of SharePoint sites?
Yeah, so we identified three specific ways that SharePoint sites function. We're looking at a team site, communication site, and the last one being a hub site. And if we were to take the different sites, they're really important because it allows you to share information in a different way, more in a open landscape versus a linear progression. So for a team site, very important, very simple. Let's say you've got a projects team or a special event that you're planning. You would create a team site and add all the people to that site, and they would be able to share their content, get follow-up updates on that project, and give everybody the information that they need. And all the files would be accessible through that team site. And you can create as many as you like.
Yeah, it's a different way to look at it, right? You can go project to project, because some people work in project teams that move around quite a bit. Some people, everybody's got different departments in the company. So setting up team sites based on departments is, as you mentioned, is a really good way of doing it. And it forces a little bit of a shift away from some of the old ways of doing things with file servers, that you're more kind of looking and thinking about setting things up how people are working.
Right.
As opposed to a storage point for data.
And it looks nice.
Yeah.
So here's a great example, right? We've got a project team, product launch event. You want to add everybody in there, and somebody makes a change, adds a new file, updates a file. Everybody in the team gets notified and they're able to see what those changes are. And they can go ahead and add and update it as it goes along and keep everybody on the same page.
All right, let's talk about communication sites. Number two.
So communication sites are great. If we were to take a, we've taken a poll, we've had some questions from other clients that we've supported. Everybody's got some form of a way they exchange information with their staff and company-wide. Make new announcements, whether it's an acquisition, a new product line, somebody's birthday. Communication sites are set up as an intranet version to allow you to share information wide open. So it's not restricted like a team site for a specific project or anything. It's a public open site that allows anyone in your organization to add, edit, and make announcements. So it's more of a news feed that can be continually updated and used to broadcast information to everyone. Can you imagine this for the office holiday party in 2024 when we're all back from COVID? To tie this together now, what we're going to talk a little bit about is hub sites. So if you're on a primary hub site, you want to be able to say, well, I'm a member of HR, I'm a member of manager portal, I'm a member of talent acquisition and benefit. So now I've got a number of multiple sites. How do I aggregate in one place to ensure that I can access whichever one I need without going through that linear progression? So a hub site is great because now, as on my own hub site, I will have all of the sites that I'm a member of pinned on that site. And from that site, I can click and access any one of these. So now I'm not going through the drive down the folder line to get to the site that I need. I can just click on the icon on the main site and it brings me to that site with everything that I'm a member of and everything I have access to. So now it makes it way faster for me to get from point A to point B and only accessing the file I need.